Hi, my name is Emily, and in this video, I'll be teaching you how to transfer files between your CSE account and your Mac. So when you're coding from home and on your Mac, you'll have to know how to transfer files, because for example, if you're in the lab, you start coding with your lab partner, but you don't quite finish in the allocated lab hours, you have to transfer the file from your CSE server to your Mac so you can finish them at home. And then once you are finished, you'll have to transfer them back from your Mac to the CSE server so you can submit them using the give command. And to accomplish this, we'll be using the scp command on your terminal.
So if you want to copy some files from your lab files, like the ones you have on the CSE server, to your Mac, you'll have to open up your handy terminal application again. So you should have it saved in your dock over here. Click on terminal. If you do forget where you've stored your terminal application, you can always go up to the top right hand corner to spotlight, click on it, and type in terminal, and it should be the first hit that you get. So now I have my terminal open. So the first thing you'll have to remember is the file path that you stored your file in. So my previous video, I went onto my ZID account with CSE, and I created a folder called lab01, and within that I made a helloworld.c file. And that is the file I want to transfer. So since it was in the lab01 folder and its name is helloworld.c, its file path is lab01 helloworld.c. And if you ever forget how to do that, you can also type in pwd, which gives you the series of folders that you're in. You can ignore all this import atoms to N1811 test. Just after that, that's where all your files and folders start. So once you're done with that, I'll log out of my ZID account. What I want to do is, now that I'm on my Mac, I want to go to my Finder application and I want to find the folder where I want to store my files from CSE to. So I have a folder on my desktop called Coding is Awesome. So I will open that up, and right now it's empty, but I do want to store my files in here. So let's move that to the side for now. And back in our terminal application, make sure you're not connected to CSE anymore. So if you were connected to CSE, type in logout, and you'll see from over here it says Emily's MacBook Pro 2, and I'm in my demonstration user, so I know I'm not with CSE. If I was in CSE, I would see this Wagner prompt before my commands. So now that I'm in my terminal and on my local Mac computer, I will type in scp, which is the little program we're using that helps to transfer files between servers and your computer in a secure kind of way. So after scp, we have a space, and the first argument we want to put in is the address of the file on the server. So that would be the one on CSE, the helloworld.c file I have. So the first thing I type in is my ZID. So that specifies which user at CSE I want to log into. So Z555555. Make sure you enter in your ZID, not the one I have here, and then the address that it's stored at, which is the same address you use to log in with SSH. And then separated by a colon, we have the file path of the folder. So in that case, that would be lab01 and then helloworld.c. And then we put in another space, and after that, we want to specify where on our Mac, so the machine that we're on right now, do we want to transfer the file from CSE to. So that would be this Coding is Awesome folder that I have on my desktop. So a shortcut of finding the file path instead of navigating through all my files and folders and figuring out where everything's stored is just to click on it in Finder and then drag it into my terminal, and it will paste the file path there. So now we have all the components we need. The first thing was the scp command. The second part was the address of the file on CSE servers we want to transfer. And the last thing is the file path on our computer that we want the files to transfer to. So we click enter, and it will prompt you for the password of your CSE account. So type it in, nothing will show up as per usual, and then click enter when you are done. And then you'll see over here, helloworld.c, that's the file that we transferred. And it said it's 100% transferred, so everything should be there. And let's just double check and go to our Finder, click on the Coding is Awesome file, and yay, we do have a helloworld.c file here. You can press the spacebar to see a preview of the code. So let's say that we want to edit this file a little bit. I will open it up in a text editor. If you want more details about this, I will cover how to code locally on your Mac in another video. But for now, let me just edit it a little bit and say that I am now on my Mac. I'll save the file. Went to file, save. I will close out of Sublime. And now you can see in the preview that my file has now been changed. I am now on my Mac. And let's just rename the file. So we can right click on it and click rename, Hello World. Let's call it Hello Mac. So now we know it's a different file. And what if we now want to transfer this file back onto CSE servers to submit it for an assignment? So what we'd want to do is we want to go back to our handy terminal application and use SCP again. So what we do is we type in SCP, and this time we want to enter the file path of where the file is stored on our Mac first, because now we're going from Mac to CSE. So the first thing we put in is the file path for our file. We can do this by going to our Finder, finding the file, and then clicking and dragging it into terminal. And then it automatically inserts a space for you. And after the space, we type in the address at CSE that we want to store it in. So the first thing that you always do is put in your ZID at cse.unisw.edu.au, separate by a colon. That's the folder you want to store your files in. And in this case, I want to put it into Lab 01. So now everything's done, I click enter. I will type in my ZPass. And again, we see the same thing. It's 100% transferred, so it should be there. Let's just SSH in into our account to check. And if you forget how to do that, I did cover logging in remotely into your CSE servers from your Mac in a previous video. It'll prompt you for a password again. And now everything's there. So let's navigate to our Lab 01 folder. And we can type in ls. And we see there is a new file here. It's called hellomac.c. So if we so now we know that we have transferred files successfully from our Mac to our CSE servers. So if you are lazy, there are different ways to do this. If you want, you could always just copy and paste it in. So if I SSH in again and make sure I use the hyphen Y flag so I can use gedit. Enter in my ZPass. And I can navigate to my Lab 01 folder. List all the files that are there. And let's just open up a new file called blink.c. And we put in the ampersand to tell the computer that we still want to use terminal after we've opened this up. So we hit enter and we wait for xquartz to open as well with gedit. While that's happening, we can open up on our Finder the file, the C file that we have and that we edited. So I'll open it up with Sublime Text, which is a text editor. And what I can do is I can just highlight all this code, copy it, and then paste it into my gedit window. And then I can click save. And technically that's another way of transferring files. However, I would not recommend it because what if I had a really, really long program and I only copied up to return zero, but not that last brace. It's something really small, it's easy to miss, but when you copy it in, you'll probably get a compilation error once you're testing it out on CSE servers. That's really, might be hard to find, but it's a very simple thing. So just use SCP to make sure you don't make those mistakes. Another way of doing things is to use CyberDuck, which is an application that provides a graphical interface for all of your files and folders. I generally don't use CyberDuck because it is an extra application you have to download, and if you're wary about space on your computer, you might not want to do that. So SCP works fine, but if you ever get really frustrated with the terminal, CyberDuck is an option. So to do that, we go to Safari, go to Google, and we type in CyberDuck, which is the application we want to download. It should be the first result in Google. We click on that. scroll down, and we want to download CyberDuck for Mac. So we click on that. And again, it will download to our downloads folder. So when you see this little rubber ducky in your downloads folder, you'll know that it's downloaded successfully. And this is different from downloading Xcords. You don't have an installer. This is the icon for the application. So what we want to do is open it in Finder. Click there. And we want to go to File, New Tab. And in this new tab, we'll go to our Applications folder, click back to our Downloads tab, and we just want to transfer this CyberDuck application into our Applications folder because it makes the most sense for it to live there, and we'll be able to find it because you might often clear your downloads. So we just click and drag, and if you go to Applications and scroll down, you'll see your new CyberDuck over there. So you can double-click on that to open up the application. You click Open, you download it from the internet, but yes, you are sure you want to open it. You can set it as default if you want. I'll just click cancel for now. And you probably should check automatically for updates if you want to be using this. So once you have CyberDuck open, go to the left side and click on Open Connection. You want to change the protocol to SFTP. So if you see that familiar SSH, that's how we logged in using our terminal. And the server, we want to type in cse.unisw.edu.au. That's the last bit that we had when we SSH in. We had SSH, our ZID, at, and then CSE, this address. So that's the server that our account is stored at. Your username would be your ZID. And your password, if it doesn't already remember it, is your ZPass. And once everything's entered, you can click Connect. And login successful. Now you can see all your files and folders over here. So I click on Labo 1. I can see, ooh, there's all the files that I want. So if I wanted to transfer that blank.c file into my coding is awesome file folder on my desktop, I just click on CyberDuck, click on the file, and drag it over to the Finder application. And it'll tell you that it's uploaded some files. You think that's great, and if you click on the space bar to preview the file, you'll see, yes, that is the file that I made. So that is how you use CyberDuck. Now you can drag and drop files between your CSE account and your home computer.
So good job! Now you know how to transfer files between the CSE servers and your Mac. To summarize, there are a few ways to do this. I recommend using your terminal application and the scp command because it is nice and easy. You don't need to install too many other things. However, there are a few lazy methods as well. One of them is to simply open up gedit while connected to the CSE servers on your terminal and copy and paste from your Mac to the CSE server. But remember, that is not the best method and you'll probably get a lot of bugs doing that. And another method is to use CyberDuck, which is a graphical application that lets you drag and drop files between your CSE server and your computer. So now that you know how to do files transfers between the CSE server and your Mac, you probably also want to know how to code on your Mac. If you want to find out more, please watch my next video. Thank you.